G'day guys, Jake from Make Science Fun. Something totally radically different for this episode. Almost like a vlog. It's actually a short talk that I did last week at this pub where I had exactly 5 minutes and behind me was a PowerPoint showing with 20 slides and each slide lasted 15 seconds and I had no control over them. It was one of the toughest talks I've ever had to do. So the spherical periodical table. Some of you are thinking, hit that stop button, let's go find something fun because this is not what I was expecting. But hang tight. The periodic table is like a really, really important thing in science and I reckon that someone is going to win a Nobel Prize for coming up with this spherical periodical table. Now you guys know that I've been a science teacher for quite some time. I know it's hard to believe given these great looks of mine, you know, but those chemicals do have a preservative effect. Now here's these two images are from a good friend of mine, Paul, from Stone Meadow Photography. You should definitely check out his site. He has got some awesome photos. When I first started at this school, a teacher said, oh, he looks like Ken, but he sounds a bit like Barbie. Anyway, everybody knows Sam and loves Sam. Now he's sticking out his tongue for a very important reason. He's sticking out his tongue to sort of tell us that science teachers are liars. And a lie that I've been told in the past by a science teacher is this concept of tongue zones. And that is that your tongue is divided up into four zones and they tell you what the zones are, like salty, bitter, sour, and they get you to put chemicals on your tongue and then they said, do you taste the salt? Do you taste the sugar? And you're like, yeah, I taste the salt. I taste the sugar. Yeah, I'm pretty sure my tongue's got these zones, right? Well, it's an absolute fallacy. There is just no evidence for it whatsoever. The second lie that is perpetuated by science teachers is this thing called ontogeny recapitulates phylogeny. And that is that as we go through as we develop as embryos, that we go through these evolutionary cycles that, you know, we sort of like look like things that our ancestors look like. Well, Haeckel actually fraudulently doctored the photos to make it look like that. It was a lie. Lie number three, periodic table. Now the periodic table is not a lie in itself. I mean, it contains all the elements that, you know, we love, gold and silver and sulfur and all the rest of it. Here's the periodic table that we give to our students. Now I wish I had a dollar for every periodic table like this I gave to my students. I'd be a millionaire. But you know, there's something significantly wrong with this periodic table. And the hint is down below. Do you see the lanthanides and the actinides and how they're highlighted there? They're highlighted there because in the real periodic table, they don't belong there. In fact, getting a periodic table like this is actually like getting a picture of a snake, which has been like chopped in the middle, pulled the middle out, the two ends stuck together, and the teacher going, here, stick this picture of a snake in. Now, that would just be a lie because everybody knows that the snake doesn't look like that. In fact, that's what a snake looks like. It's nice and long. And in fact, the real periodic table that Mendeleev came up with is really nice and long. And of course, the problem with it is it doesn't actually fit in your book. And so that's why we give you the shortened version. And it got me thinking that it just doesn't seem right. In this world where there's complexity, but there's so much simplicity and so much geometry as well. For example, the solar system. You know, you've got the planets which are orbiting in these circular. A guy called Kepler came up with this idea. He had all this mathematical data and he came up with this beautiful, simple model. So many things in science have been like that. So Faraday was able to explain electromagnetism by circular fields around current flowing electricity. And if you look at something as complex as like this lacewing, then if you look carefully at the wings, you'll notice that the wings have got these beautiful, repeating, simple pattern. And so I've spent years on the periodical table. I've spent years developing this new sphere. And today is my great launch so that it can be analysed and understood. And here it is. What? Oh no. Oh no, it's all pixelated. I can't make it out. Oh, I'm so sorry. Something must have gone wrong with the slide. That's all right. I'll fix it up and I'll get it to you next time. Oh. my life's work. But anyway, I might not ever win a Nobel Prize, but at least I've done my best to make science fun for you tonight. So I'll see you guys later. Bye.